Caesar's Palace is a huge offer.
Okay.
If I had to do a concert tomorrow, I couldn't do it.
I want to hear you. People want to hear you.
I find it really strange holding a microphone. I was doing fantastic. And it fell by the wayside.
For some reason, I'm not comfortable singing in front of people anymore.
I have lost my ability to sing. I've lost it.
Don't expect more. This is amateur night.
I need to sing again. It wasn't one crisis that made me lose my voice. It was my childhood poverty, my parents' death.
I was a workaholic, and my marriage was falling apart.
My own friend had an affair with my husband. What if I can never sing again? Never been so miserable in my whole life. I just had to snap out of it.
So I'm getting out on this tour, trying to find my voice again.
I want to talk to people that have been through similar struggles.
My husband left with my best friend.
I wanted what she had.
She trusted you.
I'm taking myself out of my comfort zone.
Stop sugarcoating it.
That was, like, so private.
Why don't you scare the heck out of yourself and go sing a song with Lionel Richie?
I will be inspired by other people.
The more you do it, the stronger you're gonna get.
Share my own experience.
Our own parents have died this year, actually.
Maybe that will inspire them.
Exactly.
The people I brought with me are the people that I really love and trust.
Let's go then.
Life's two most important questions are why and why not. The trick is knowing which one to ask.
On the last leg of the journey,
and I'm so grateful I've gone through this process.
She's starting a race.
I think I've learned more about myself in the last 6 months than I have through my whole life.
Here, this is the hill. You can do it.
Get to the top of the hill.
Just give it just enough pressure.
Know that you can and you will get to the top of the hill.
So you have to find a nice trail. We'll find it. We're gonna have a drink of coconut.
I appreciate Fred more than I've ever appreciated a relationship in my life. Fred's helped me evolve and gain perspective over my separation and the end of my marriage from Mutt.
What about here? Are those one there?
There was a time that I felt quite angry that I'd spent 14 years in a marriage. 14 years of my prime years, I sort of felt, you know? But what I've come to accept and be quite peaceful about is that it's beautiful just the way it was. And what I have now is just different. And it's its own thing. And it deserves its own respect.
He's like such a good man.
And this time it will be different.
That's how you do it in the Bahamas. Mm.
Fred is just an angel.
Very good, huh?
He loves her so unconditionally.
It's good.
You should open up the whole thing because it's good
fresh
jelly in there.
I haven't seen my sister live and love ever like this before. And she so deserves that.
Take the straw out, beauty.
If I had been granted this relationship earlier on in my life, maybe I wouldn't have known what to do with it.
A little hit, that's enough.
Oh, look there, look.
There's still some juice in it.
Yeah, I'm gonna just chew it right from there.
I mean, I'm still growing. Of course, I have a long way to go, but I can just say now at this point in my life from here, I've never loved so completely. Right from the beginning, Fred was my most understanding friend because he's been through the exact same thing. It was giving, loving, caring, supporting. I knew I could rely on that.
You look
good. I know, right?
You look a little bit goofy.
Oh, do I? Should I get a different beer? Oh!
And then when he started to fall in love with me, I said, whoa, this isn't something I'm ready to do.
It's a sexy lady coming in.
But it didn't matter. He just loved me anyway.
I think there's just something really beautiful about that.
I am in love for the first time of my life. I know it.
know it because my heart feels different, because when she enters a room, it's like I'm just, everything stops, my heart stops, I'm like totally numb. It's just a beautiful thing, you know?
No, you're not supposed to look at my mom.
She did fall in love with me, and I'm just the happiest man on the planet. What can I say? I mean, she's just the most amazing human being.
Is your relationship really that perfect? Do you never fight?
Yeah, well, I mean, we never fight. We do have our discussions, but it's just a very beautiful relationship.
What can I say? You know, I just have this amazing relationship that's come out of something very difficult.
I just prepared the beach for you. Woke up early this morning and just prepared it for you. Look at this beach. I mean, it's phenomenal.
Just jump in my arms.
Oh, yeah?
Full confidence.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Where'd you go?
Like that. Perfect. We rehearsed it a few times before.
Ah, this is so beautiful. I don't feel like I've ever been loved this way before. No, no way. I have never been considered this way ever in my life before. I've never been supported this way in my life before. I have never been charmed this way in my life before. I've never been romanced this way in my life before. In all senses, I have never felt this way before. It was a simple dress. I didn't want to be really elaborate there, but I loved the drama of the really long veil, and I indulged in that. That was a bit of a fairy tale moment. And it was very precious to be able to walk down the aisle with my son, Asia. That was just our little thing together. It was really beautiful. The vows were more of a promise to remain inspired and optimistic as a team and as a partnership. And we based them on the song Today.
Today is your day to begin.
We won't give up.
Don't give up.
We won't quit.
Don't you quit.
Our moment is now. This is it. And then came
the I do's, and they were beautiful. That goes by too fast. I mean, I do is so short.
Will you make this woman, Eileen, to be your wedded wife?
I absolutely will.
Will you, Eileen, make this man, Fred, to be your wedded husband?
I do.
Today is your day, and nothing can stand in your way.
The ring exchange is more traditional.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token.
Providing love. Providing love.
Promise. Nothing can stand in your way.
My favorite part of the whole ceremony was the kiss. I felt girlish at that moment. I feel kind of silly saying it, but it was all sort of like a seal on things. I don't know. So that particular kiss, out of all the kisses that we've had, was just very precious.
Sorry.
Yeah, it was just beautiful all the way around. I just feel so entirely loved. It's beautiful. Lionel Richie
is a huge star.
Why am I doing that wrong?
I'm facing my biggest challenge of this whole journey.
You guys have no idea what I'm going through with my voice. Through this whole journey of mine, I've been fortunate to sit with some people who gave great advice and share their incredible insight with me.
Well, it's good to see you again.
It's so good to see you.
I'm so glad to be here. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you. Dr. Livingston has become a real important part of my journey.
Oh, we're very happy.
Yeah, I can believe it.
So lots of change and lots of things to talk about.
Yes, indeed. All good, sounds like.
It's all good.
I've learned so much in this time that I almost feel like I just want to sit around and talk about what I've learned.
And get started and catch up.
Yes, indeed.
Not that everything's been answered, but I feel a lot more resolve all the way around. Thank you for rejoining me again on this journey.
It's a pleasure, Shania.
It's not been an easy one, but you have been like an anchor throughout the whole thing.
Oh, thank you.
And what I've found is that no matter what kind of loss that devastates us, whether it's illness or death or the breakdown of a marriage, the grieving process is pretty much the same cycle. Once you've experienced an emotional crisis, you can't just say, well, that's it, I've decided I'm not going to feel that.
Yeah, and it brings us to the reality that we don't really have much control over our feelings, our thoughts. The only thing that we control is our behavior, which is why when we respond to these unwanted feelings, it's got to be behaviorally. It's not by suppressing them or wishing that they would evaporate.
And what I found that I've done throughout my whole life is I do try to control my reactions. And then I ended up doing what you just said. I suppressed a lot of it. And I think I will spend a lot of time still finding that equilibrium and that balance.
But it's interesting. One of your reactions was to become rather perfectionistic, which is really, that pays off for people. It makes them good at what they do. But behind that perfectionism lurks fear.
Yes.
And I think that's what you're finding.
I can't say that I'm comfortable confronting things that scare me, but by doing it more often, I'm getting more comfortable with the fact that on the other side of it, I'm okay.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I always say, unless you have three good reasons why not to do something, you really should do it.
Someone once said, a lot of people die with their music still inside them.
Yes.
And in some ways, that's the definition of courage, moving forward even though you're afraid. Courage isn't fearlessness. It's just the ability to keep going when you're experiencing fear. And sometimes it takes a crisis, such as you've been through, to bring us face to face with that and realize where our strength lies.
You're right. It took one more crisis with my marriage to make me realize it is just no fun living in this pretend world of I'm okay, everything's all right, when I'm not all right.
In that sense, it was a disguised blessing, wasn't it? I mean, you wouldn't have chosen this, but once you were forced into coping with it, it's, I think, turned out to be a really important experience for you.
Yeah. Well, I feel very grateful that I've, for some reason, this time around, in this crisis, I have finally found the courage to be different. I can't live and try to just pretend that everything's okay. So the me now has a different perception on things.
Yeah.
Overall.
As long as we can keep faking it, I'll fake Lionel Richie and you fake Shania. We got it going on.
Through the process of this journey, I've gone through experiences pushing myself for the sake of growing, for the sake of evolving, and for the sake of getting used to what it feels like to face your fears. Now I'm facing my biggest challenge of this whole journey. Lionel is a huge star, which is scary.
All night long. Whoa.
So the chance to work with Lionel Richie is a double-edged sword. Of course, I would love to have worked with Lionel Richie, but to sing a song with Lionel Richie and to sing Endless Love scared the heck out of me. It was a real process making the decision to sing this song. Right off the bat, it was a no. I can't do that.
I wanted Shania because, A, I've been a fan forever, and B, because she's not been out in the public eye for so long.
I was just extremely apprehensive about singing again, period. Never mind singing a classic like that.
And then it became an obsession, and then it became Lionel Richie stalking Shania.
He'd call again, and my manager would call me, and I'd get asked again, are you sure you don't want to do the Lionel thing? Are you sure you're not ready to give this a try?
And then when I found out what her little problem was, what she thought about, she's been off too long, she's worried about her voice, well, I just went through that. I did the exact same thing.
My father was dying, so I had to sit through that with him and take that journey with him. At the same time, my marriage was falling apart, and I realized that from the pressure and all of this stuff, I had polyps on my vocal cords. So I asked the doctor, when can I sing? He said, tomorrow if you want to. Now the psychological part. Okay, now that he told me I can sing, can I sing? The more time you take off, the more that little voice inside of you says, I can't, I don't know, I'm not sure. And then finally one day, it clicks. And you walk out on stage, and you think, can I do an hour and a half to 2 hour show? And about 20 minutes into the show, you forgot you ever had a surgery, because that's where we live, on that stage, you know? So Shania in front of that microphone, I'm not worried about it. Shania on stage, I'm not worried about it. It's sitting behind the scenes talking about it that can mess you up forever.
He'd already been very patient and waited, even though I had already said, well, you know, I can't do this. He still didn't fill the slot.
And so I just said to my people and to her people, if you just give me a moment to talk to her, I think it'll be just fine.
The phone call, my heart was racing when I phoned him.
And I explained to her, I'm scared to death too. The only way we're gonna get through this is you gotta step forward.
Being afraid just wasn't a good enough reason. I had to practice what I was preaching to myself and say, well, why not sing with Lionel Richie? Why miss out on that just because you're afraid? I'm petrified. I just don't think I can do it. But I wanted to hold up a good front.
All right.
There we go.
And I said to myself, force yourself to go through it. You can't avoid it. It's happening right now. Everybody else is relying on me at this point.
And these are my engineers that I brought from Nashville, Steve Martin, Antonio.
You know, managers and agents, and the pressure of being the performer grew. I didn't want anybody to know that I was freaking out internally.
Now I ask the question, does she look uptight?
No.
I rest my case.
You brought her to paradise.
We as artists, we are egotistical maniacs with inferiority complexes. So up until the time we walk on stage, or up until the time we actually walk in the studio, there's always doubt as to whether we can actually do that.
It's like such a production that makes me nervous because so many people around.
There's a point that's going to happen today with her. She's going to stop thinking about it. The first couple of notes, she'll think about it. And then she's going to listen to herself. And then she's going to realize, I'm on now.
I was feeling inadequate and insecure.
Yes, she has vocal limitations.
Yeah!
I don't know what they are.
Oh, this is so
this where you're gonna be.
Mm-hmm. Nice and dry sounding in here.
Yeah.
So it's pretty good. I think it'll be hard for me to give you a proper performance from start to finish. It'll be a lot easier if I'm just, you know, isolating a section, just repeating it over and over, let me jam through it. Even if the timing isn't always in the right place, you can just put it wherever you want it after.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
And then you guys can make whatever you want out of it. I'm not proud of the way I sound right now. I don't have the confidence. And when I'm singing someone else's song, I'm genuinely, you know, you have to then interpret that melody and the phrasing to work for your voice.
But you know what? It's okay. Just make it you. Mm-hmm. And if you want to go off the beaten trail, go off.
It's not like I feel I need to stylize it or anything like that, but I'm singing around my own vocal limitations right now, so that's more what it is. It's not because I'm going to want to give you, it's not because I want to change or restyle the song. I wish I could just do it exactly like what you need, but.
Yes, she has vocal limitations. I don't know if they are, but we will.
But I'm telling you they're there, so yes, you're trusting right, me.
I trust you on the fact that, yeah, and we call that just until she starts singing.
It's gonna be good.
Well, I thought it'd be cool to like just run the song a couple times in the great room.
Yes.
Without all of this,
yep.
And just you and Lionel sing it down.
Just jam it through a little bit.
Yeah.
Wow.
Forever.
I'm embarrassed to sing out loud. It's almost like I have to force myself through the embarrassment so that I can just start relaxing about the reality of what I sound like now.
Two hearts.
Is that my part?
That's
yes.
Right.
Da, 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 da.
Two hearts than the beat.
Okay, wait, sorry. Two, I know where I'm supposed hearts. To go that I didn't go there.
No, two.
I start with harmony there, don't
yeah,
I?
I go two hearts.
Two hearts.
Two hearts that beat as one.
I also feared that I just wasn't living up to what I should. That scared me more than anything, I think, really.
My endless love.
I'll get that right. I need to be on the mic for that.
Well, that's, save that.
I really do need to be on the mic for it, because it's
No, but
it's got to be in my ears. Now I have to brace myself.
I'm not even worried about it.
It's time to record and actually sing it for real. I just don't think I can do it.
He's worried about it. Oh, come on, girlfriend.
Listen, it's not every day you get to sing with Lionel Richie, okay?
Did I just say that in the room?
You did. You said the same exact thing.
Excuse me.
Mutual Admiration Society.
Don't worry about it, sister.
You guys have no idea what I'm going through with my voice. It's a big ass deal.
But what I love, we can't tell, so don't
worry. Okay.
As long as we can keep faking it, I'll fake Lionel Richie and you fake Shania. We got it going on.
Lionel made it as easy as it could have been. And that helped relax me and get me in the mode of everything.
Lionel, before you start, will you just explain to us why we're in this bedroom?
Because Shania has an inferiority complex.
No. We wanted to accommodate this beautiful artist who said, I need some place where I can just get into the song. I can't do this, I can't do that.
I was scared. This whole experience about facing my fears, I'm facing
a
friggin' big one right now.
Let's do verse one, and then let's do verse two.
It's too late now. Now I gotta just roll with it. Here we go.
Yes! Where's that uptight woman that came in the door?
Y'all ready?
I am so ready.
I was feeling anxious and uncomfortable because I never even ever had to prepare for a vocal performance. I just stepped out and that was it, and there I was. And right now I'm just not there yet, and it put a lot of pressure on me.
Two hearts.
Mm.
Two hearts that beat as one.
Sorry, let's do that again.
Two hearts. Two hearts.
Two hearts.
Yeah. Yes. You know what? I want to change that around. So if it's two hearts, if I go two, you are two hearts, right?
Two hearts.
So the two hearts. I'll do.
So I go two hearts.
Yeah. And I'll go two, three, four.
Two hearts that beat as one. He was just directing the melody and wanted me to try this and try that.
Tell me.
There were definitely moments where I had to experiment to find my way through that song. And I did have to make it my own in some areas in order for it to work.
No, I can't do it again.
I don't know what I did there.
No, it's good.
Through the whole thing, I'm thinking, uh-oh, we're going to get to this section, and I don't know what I'm going to do. I've already started now the song in this key, and what am I going to do? Say, guys, we have to start over again because I'm never going to reach those notes, or I'm going to reach them with a mousy voice. I'm not going to do justice to them. And I was anticipating getting to that point of the song where it was just, you know, big and powerful and all the things that I've been lacking in my voice, this power.
Oh, yes.
That's gonna be hard. Okay.
Yeah.
I gotta gear up for that.
No.
Sure, I'm not so sure it's still right.
No. It's good. Play that one back.
It's a strange note.
Yeah, no. I'm sure.
Maybe I'll do it more like that.
Yes. Right. Yeah, but I'll be that fool for you.
Okay. Thank you.
I could have said, listen, you know, I don't want to get myself that far out on a limb. Can we bring this right down to a comfortable key for myself?
I don't want her to push. None of this. So here's what I do.
I put it in your voice.
No. Got it.
But I didn't. I didn't do that. I decided that I would give it a try first in the higher range. I just thought, while I'm at it, let's go with this. And I started to work my way through it. And I just got it right on.
I'll be the fool. Okay.
That's good.
Okay. God dang, sister.
And I surprised myself, and you know, he was all excited, and it was really fantastic. I thought, wow, I haven't, you know, sung with that kind of power in years.
Do you hear distortion? Are you getting distortion?
I feel like I am. For this section, will you back up from the mic?
Yes. About
that? There you go.
There we go.
It was a compliment to be asked to step back away from the microphone. You're distorting the microphone. To get enough volume to distort a microphone, you've got to push pretty hard. So that was really great. It was like a triumph, you know. I was just energized and inspired, you know. Now I really felt like I know what I'm supposed to do. Now I've got to really go for it.
My first love.
Sing it, girl.
You're every breath that I take. You're every step I make.
And once I got in the mode, I was enjoying it, really.
I'm sure.
What I discovered, it was, I've got to sing it like Shania Twain.
My first love, you're every breath that I take, you're every step I make. Forever, I'll hold you close in my arms. I can't resist. Your charms.
Nice.
Do you notice how free she is now?
And I did it. You know, it feels kind of good, actually. It's very rewarding.
Welcome back, Shania. Welcome back. And by the way, I told you so. Thank you very much.
The whole thing has to be reshot. I healed right there. Heal. Put it on.
Man, I can't even tell you what today did for me, really.
First of all, let me just congratulate you. You came to me and you said, I'm going to do this, but I'm not quite sure. And now we're sitting here after the session. If you're not quite sure now, then something seriously is wrong with you. Okay? Because you nailed it.
And I'm just glad that I was a part of the first step out, because that's my wonderful fortune of having her with me on this.
Not only did I get a song with you, which is unbelievable, but I found a brand new old friend.
Yeah.
You understand me?
That's
the part that works.
Yeah.
I cherish that the most.
Yeah, me too. This has been really beautiful.
Thank you.
You've done a really beautiful thing for me.
I wish for her, you know, the best of the rest of her life from here on.
My first love.
Oh, cut it. Now she's singing.
Every breath.
She's cured. She's cured, ladies and gentlemen. And you too. You too can sing. Come. Come, let me talk to you, friends.
Oh, my God. The whole thing has to be reshot. Because the whole buildup was because her voice was not there.
Yeah, now we can redo the
whole thing. My voice went out.
No.
Her voice came in.
No, it was a tactic. It was a tactic.
I used to use that in the pool room.
She suckered you. It's a whole ruse.
It's a whole ruse. You didn't know that.
The thing is, now I can't stop. Now she can't stop.
Oh, put that down. Oh, my God.
What I realized today is that everything that I need in my voice is there. And that was a big deal for me. I do feel sort of healed.
Oh, God.
I can scream again.
There you go.
I realized that it's possible. And that was a beautiful surprise. This has been the most amazing journey. It's changed my life forever. Talking face to face with people about hard, difficult subjects, opening myself to hearing what they have to say, allowing myself to voice what I have to say, it's inevitable that you're going to learn and grow from that. I would never have done this by myself, I can tell you that right now. I was able to go there because I've got people like Carrie and Fred in my life. I trusted completely that they would be their beautiful selves, giving, loving, caring, supporting. I knew I could rely on that. That's a big part of what gave me the courage to do this in the first place. She faced so many of her fears head on and made it through them. To be able to have experienced this with her and to see where it's ended up, I'll never ever know how to explain how great that makes me feel.
I discovered so many things about her life that she never really talked about before, and that she's able to stand up again, share all of her incredible energy and inspire others and love again. She's progressed tremendously.
I can't say I'm on past the fear of it all, but I've taken the challenges on as I've gone. And every time I go through the challenge, I experience relief at the other side of it. I will always now, I think, take the chance and take the risk. You know, at the end of this particular journey, there will be another beginning to look forward to. And by the time it comes around, I'll be much more prepared just because I've grown.
So the obvious question at the end of this journey is, well, We want her to perform. Why not perform?
Why not?
Why not?
Well, I mean, to be honest, you know, the series isn't even long enough for that. We'd have to go. I mean, and I am performing. No, I'm making excuses.
But it's a good point. Am I ready to go back out to sing in public?
If I was being really truthful with myself and asking myself that core question, why not? My answer would have been because, well, I'm afraid and I just need a little bit more time. You know, I need a little bit more time. But I've reached the point where I can say that is a very natural next step. Getting up on the stage again. And I can say that I comfortably decide even without fear, really, because I've tested myself so rigorously through this process. So that's where I'm going. Or that's at least where I'm heading. Whether I get there or not, it doesn't matter. But that's where I'm headed. Now, for the very first time, the song I wrote especially for this journey. The world premiere of Today Is Your Day.
You got what it takes, you can win. You got what it takes, you can win. Today is your day to begin. Don't give up here, don't you quit. The moment is now, this is it. I know that you can, then you will. Get to the top of the hill. Part of the fun is the climb. You just gotta make up your mind. That today is your day, and nothing can stand in your way. Today is your day, everything's going your way. Today, 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 today. When somebody throws sticks and stones, all they can break are your bones. And life's gonna kick you around, and then kick you again when you're down. But today is your day, and nothing can stand in your way. Today is your day, and everything's going your way. Today. This is as good as it gets. Don't expect more or less. Just go out and give it your best. Today.